Imagine a world where no one has to wait for an organ transplant. A world where doctors can simply print a new heart or kidney for every patient. It sounds like science fiction, and for now it still is. But 3D printing is bringing us closer to this future. Today, scientists can print simple human tissues like skin and cartilage. Some companies and labs are even working on small functional organ structures. But printing a full working organ? That's still a big challenge. So how does 3D bioprinting work? What progress has been made? And what obstacles still stand in the way? To help answer these questions, we interviewed two experts in the field. Today, there are two main applications of 3D printed organs. The first is surgical models, anatomical replicas used for medical training and practice. These models look and feel like real human organs. They have the same shape, texture, and even simulate bleeding, but they are not functional. The second type of 3D printed organs are bioprinted organs. These are printed with living cells and are intended to be functional. Bioprinting is a technology that uses 3D printing to create living organs and tissues. The bioprinting process involves printing layer by layer with living cells, often combined with biocompatible materials called biomaterials. These cells are carefully arranged in three-dimensional structures to form tissues that mimic real organic tissue. But why use 3D bioprinting to create tissues and organs?
So I think the main advantage is exactly on the morphology of the tissues you can create. When we discuss complex tissues, which have a very complex 3D architecture, so as I mentioned, different cells in different positions, and the position of these cells is very, very important for that kind of tissue, then it's fundamental that you have a technology that allows you to deposit these cells in the right place and in the right position.
There's more to it than just these benefits. 3D printed organs are unlocking new possibilities in medical research and training, giving researchers a chance to explore organ structures and experiment with new approaches.
Right now, 3D printed tissue is mostly used for research applications. Research applications meaning researchers, for instance, in academia who want to understand how a disease works in a specific kind of tissue, or a drug developer like a pharma company that wants to know if a specific drug is toxic or not for different kinds of tissues.
Which technologies are most widely used? There are many different 3D bioprinting technologies. In fact, many companies create their own technologies. But the two main technologies that have become important in the market are extrusion and stereolithography.
Basically, we are talking about a technique where you are extruding the material of the cells from a syringe. So you will combine the cell with material put inside of the syringe, and the printer will extrude just like FDM, let's say. And the other side, we are talking about like a light-based cross-linking of bioresins. So differently from synthetic resins, we are talking about biological resins together or not with cells. So of course, if we are talking about bioprinting, it should be with cells.
Stereolithography is an interesting technology because it offers high resolution, lower cost, and flexibility. However, despite its advantages, 99% of researchers and companies use extrusion-based technology for printing organs, as it's the most efficient for creating large parts. That said, there are still other technologies being explored.
There is now a lot of volumetric bioprinting. This volumetric bioprinting is also interesting to do large parts. Drawbacks are that so far it's just one component, so you cannot mix different components or different cells at the same time, but maybe it will come. So I think most of the time it's extrusion based, also because when you do extrusion based system, the material you use can be a material from medical grade. So all the material we use usually are from medical grade. So it means that as soon as you reach organs, you can implant that because it's already using validated materials.
After looking at the main technologies used for 3D printing organs, it's important to understand the actual process. The first step is the design, which is not very different from conventional 3D printing. We need to create the right model, which can be done using 3D modeling software, for example. The second step is very important because it's the preparation stage. You need the right cells, the right amount of cells, and the right materials, and then combine them properly before placing them in the bioprinter. The third step is the printing itself. And the fourth step is maturation. This step is crucial because after printing, the tissue or organ is far from ready. To make it a real tissue, we need to mature it.
This maturation can be done in different ways depending on the tissue we are talking about. So if we are talking about like a bone tissue, then basically you have to compress it. If we are talking about muscle tissue, you have to like stretch it. So if we are talking about heart valves, you have to have the flow just as you have in the heart to mimic the movement of the valves and stimulate the alignment of the cells in the position of the right ECM. So every different tissue will require a different maturation step.
From design to maturation, the time needed to create a 3D printed tissue depends on its complexity. Simple tissues can be ready in about a month, while more complex ones can take several months. But the process is not easy. There are many challenges and difficulties in 3D printing an organ or a tissue.
So one difficulty of the printing itself is sterility. Sterility has always been something quite difficult to achieve because these machines are open, they're not designed for sterility. So that's one big part. Then also, quality control during the print, it's also something quite a challenge. So far in the standard machine you can buy, there is not this quality control on flight during the printing, which have a very big impact, because if you have a small defect at layer 7, then the defect is there for all the layers after, and the shape is not what you were expecting.
Why can't we transplant 3D printed organs yet? 3D bioprinting of organs is a rapidly advancing field, but we're still not able to print fully functional, transplantable human organs. The complex biology of organ transplantation, along with the need for long-term compatibility and functionality, are challenges researchers are still working to overcome. One of the biggest hurdles is vascularization, the creation of blood vessels in bioprinted tissues. Without a functional vascular network, it's difficult to keep 3D printed organs alive and working properly.
The big thing about printing organs for transplantation, so living organs, the technology is there. I mean, that's the same technology we took from 3D printing to 3D bioprinting. Very few fine tuning of the methodology and the technologies. But then when you print a shape with cells, you just have shape with cells without activity in the biology. So I should say that bioprinting of organs is not really a problem of bioprinting. It's a problem of getting the print mature or functional enough to be implanted.
Although organ transplants aren't possible yet for many reasons, bioprinting gives hope for the future of healthcare and solving big medical problems like future organ transplants. This is the main goal of the research. While it's not possible now, progress is happening quickly. Could we one day see a full organ transplant using this technology? What do you think about the advancements in 3D printed organs? Let us know in the comments.